Welcome back to this series of Black Hat Fast Chats. I am joined now by Carl Klasing, Director of Product Marketing and Security Operations for ServiceNow. Carl, thanks for joining us again. It's a delight to see you again.
Pleasure. Looking forward to it, Terry.
So in the world we find ourselves working in, malware and ransomware, phishing, the incidences are off the charts. Talk about how automating your incident response can begin to help InfoSec teams take on this dramatic new increase.
It's a great question. It's been a long year for all of us, right? Just incredible if we think about it. And when you touch on malware, and I think what we've seen is such a transformation of the threats and the potential breaches and how things have gone. You know, in 2019, when you mentioned malware, under a third of all malware was paid out. In 2020, over half was paid out. I mean, it's just dramatic, right? And we ended the year with an 894% increase in Microsoft, Teams monthly usage. I mean, that's incredible, right? Phishing emails increased by 25% overall for the year, and incredible spikes along the way. 44,000 plus new malicious websites added each week in the second half of 2020. I mean, that one alone just scares the living life out of us. It should. So under that type of guise, like you're saying, what a year. At the end of the day, we're still doing fairly well. People are doing some of the right things. It's an overnight transformation for all of us. But there are several ways right out of the gate that between making use of automation and security response, and particularly in incidents, particularly in vulnerabilities, taking a lot of those what are mundane processes up front away allows those teams that, when you think about the numbers we just discussed, I mean, they're overwhelmed. They were overburdened to begin with before 2020 hit, right? So it's that much more.
So let me ask you there, is automation simply a means to deal with the increased volumes of malware that's flooding across servers? Or what other benefits do InfoSec pros get by
automating? It's a great question. So right out of the gate, you touch on one that's very prominent, Terry, which is how do they scale to meet this? It's daunting. So being able to take those mundane processes, like I started to mention, and actually automate some of those things, some of the investigations, some of the initial blocks, things that go on that are part of it, even threat intel lookups, take that off their plate. Make sure that just happens. That's a part of the workflow that, your security orchestration automation response solution handles, your SOAR. It just steps in and does that. Now, where another quick aspect of that kicks in, not just in being able to scale those teams to address that, but a huge area is being able to leverage what are best practice workflows, being able to actually establish what are repeatable and automated responses that are truly effective, being able to assess those automatically and get those reports daily, twice daily, whatever you want for your teams, and be able to report up, here are the evolutions that we made, here are the changes that we made, and here's where we're winning, and here's where we're challenged. I mean, if you think of being able to keep that near real-time visibility into how are we doing, that's a huge gain on top of the scale.
Well, so with these gains that we're getting from automation, it sounds like a lot, and all of it valuable. Can I ever really hope, though, to have enough insight about my attack surface to stay ahead of the cyber criminals, I guess, is my question.
No, it's a big one. It's a very big one to ask, And at the end of the day, one of the starting points by doing automation is you will naturally start to go ahead and force collaboration between IT and security operations. That's a big step in that direction. Yeah. Now, what you touch on here is, how can I stay ahead of them? How can I go ahead and have the insights I need? Well, there are some great things that you can leverage that give you those insights. And let me dive in a bit with one. We touched on automation, great. Gives us the scale, gives us some of those insights, allows our teams to focus a bit more, all good. How do we get those insights then to take that effective, repeatable automated actions? Well, we covered that. But what can you do beyond that when you think of all that data in mind? And mind you, when we open up Pandora's box, not just the threat data, but all the context data that we want to make sure those teams have to do the right things, to make the right decisions, to be accurate, that's where some things can really kick in and be incredibly helpful that way. So we're going to touch a bit now on what is MITRE ATT&CK framework and how that can be invaluable working with SOAR. Is that something you're familiar with as far as MITRE ATT&CK?
Right, right.
And for many of our, you know, for many folks here listening to us today and joining us, it's really an opportunity by taking that MITRE ATT&CK framework to think like the enemy, so to speak, right? They essentially can go ahead and get that adversary perspective, not just these are the canned workflows, the things we do, we get it. But what would a threat, you know, what would that bad actor do in my environment? What would be their next move? You know, Terry, if you and I were sitting here and playing chess, and I can read your mind and know exactly what move you're going to make every time, it would be golden, right? So that's a type of insights sure. that combining SOAR with that MITRE ATT&CK framework can really give a lot of folks out there. You know, and as a quick snapshot, MITRE is the MITRE ATT&CK framework is simply a community-based matrix that includes all the tactics, techniques, procedures, those TTPs that are essentially the profiles for threat actors. And it's used a lot to map security events to those TTPs and ultimately to particular cyber attack campaigns. You know, think of it as a guidebook of what's gonna happen next. And it's a living model, so it's constantly updated. All of us inadvertently actually contributing to it when we report different things and go through that. But again, what I give you is it's almost like a flashlight in the dark, right? When the threats first start hitting. Knowing where they'll go next, I mean, talk about shining a light in a room and seeing where everyone is. It's incredibly critical information that I might add allows them not only to continually update what they're doing, but actually know that it's going to be effective responses and be able to group those. And that way they're also doing a third item here, which is they're not being duped by a mass influx of threats. It's actually able to recognize that, hold on, that's the same bad actor, right?
Right. I assume that the MITRE ATT&CK reports are how we summarize report and are tracking these results just to give the InfoSec professionals a greater inside track on this.
Absolutely, Terry. You can actually go ahead and be able to report on, okay, what of those potential threats out there can I actually map to a MITRE technique? And you can actually have that on your dashboard. Again, a huge advantage. I love to go back to the chess game because that's really what it is. This is all a chess game at the end of the day, as we all know.
Sure.
And being able to control those pieces and know where they're going to go next and, you know, almost like the board lights up underneath them, that's fantastic. It's a huge advantage for us out there battling this type of threat.
Well, here's to checkmate of the bad guys, all customers going forward. Carl, thanks for the time today.
Always a pleasure, and hope it's beneficial or look forward to more of these.
That's great. We've been talking now with Carl Klasig from SigServiceNow. This has been Terry Sweeney for Black Hat. Thanks for joining us for this Black Hat Fast Chat.